7,107 islands, 104 million smiles. Intayon, adto ta, larga na, tara na. Via Heroes goes to Batanes.
Here in Basco Airport. Welcome to Batanes. My name is Nathaniel M. Yuni, but you can simply call me your Kuya Nathan. On behalf of Via Hero Travels and Tours, it's my pleasure to be your tour guide. Here is our coach, Captain Sir Nat. Feel free to ask our assistants if you need any help. I seems a little bit exhausted from the trip. When everyone settles for a while, let me give you a little background of this little province. Batanes, part of the Region 2 Cagayan Valley and famously known as the Home of the Winds, is the northernmost and smallest province of the Philippines with approximately 230 kilometers of total land area. This collective islands, the Batanes Islands, is located beside the West Philippine Sea and south of Taiwan. And it is actually closer to Taiwan than it is to the northern tip of Luzon. The capital of Batanes is Basco. The name Batanes derives from the word Batan, the local word for the Ibatan people. The main dialect used in this province are Ibatan, Ikbayaten, Filipino, and English.
The residing residents of this province is what we call the Ibatan people. If I were to describe these people, it would be hardworking and enduring, withstanding any storms in life. The women of Batanes are often associated with this headgear called the vakul. Made from vuyavuy palm fiber, this serves as their protection from sunlight and rain. Here in Batanes, you can actually leave your things unattended as it is said that the province has almost zero crime rate. Amazing, right?
Now that everyone's ready, allow me to give you some few reminders. In this trip, we support ecotourism. Take nothing but pictures, leave nothing but footprints. Keep nothing but memories and kill nothing but time. Weather update, it's 33 degrees Celsius with 10% chance of rain. So don't forget to put on your sunscreen and wear your sunglasses. Heads count! Coach Captain, I think we're good to go. First up, Rafo A. Tayanan. The hills are alive. It feels as if we are here at the end of the world. Raho A Payaman, or as a tourist calls the Malboro Country, would probably be the most famous tourist attraction here in Batanes.
The rich green carpets of grass, the majestic hills, and the breathtaking view of the horizon as the sky meets the Pacific Ocean, the view here was nothing short of spectacular. Don't wander too far and take as many pictures as you want. Climb aboard! Next stop, Morong Beach.
Too crowded for you, but you still want to experience the pristine white sand beach feels? Well, today's your lucky day. Let's put on our swimwear because we just arrived here at Morong Beach. This beach is the most famous here in Sabtang Island because of this iconic rock formation called Nakabuang Arc. Today is a perfect day to have a splash. Let's go!
Now that we have seen some of the natural wonders of Batanes, our next stop is something quite different. This is the House of Dahay, the oldest stone house in Batanes, built in 1887. The traditional structures of Batanes are designed to be firm, withstanding strong winds and storms.
The walls of the house are very thick and made up of stone and lime. The roofs are made in kogon grass about one-third of a meter thick. It is called Bahay ni Dakay in Ivatan after the family who originally owned it. UNESCO even acknowledged this as a World Heritage Building. Come, let's take a look inside.
Of course, the tourism experience would not be complete without trying their famous cuisines. And since I've heard some stomachs growling, let's try some Ivatan specialties. This is the Uber dish. Usually in meatball form, this dish is made of banana heart or banana stock mixed with ground beef. This is coconut crabs. These crabs are known for their sweet meat and alig, which tastes like mixture of crab fat mixed with coconut milk, bursting with creamy and sweet goodness. And of course, desserts. For desserts, we have fruit cups. These fruit cups are usually deep fried into donut shapes and then dipped in ice cream or condensed milk. Are you hearing what I'm hearing? I think it's the sound of the drums. Despite the serene and quiet ambience of this province, Ivatans do know how to celebrate and party. Let's go check it out!
What you are seeing right now is the Kulay Festival. Kulay Festival, which means anything dried. This festival highlights the simple yet colorful food heritage of the Ivatans. The main objective of this 5-day feast is to introduce locally manufactured and processed food products like products such as onion, garlic, rice, corn, and fish, among others, to local and foreign tourists visiting their province. This is the Bayanihan or Payuhuan Festival. Payuhan in Ivatan means cooperation or teamwork. In this celebration, communities and schools conduct the Ivatan Olympics to pay tribute to their native game. Another highlight of this fiesta is the Kananun Kumavahayan or the Unity Launch, a government-funded celebration for everyone.
Who says the pandemic could stop us from experiencing the wonders of the Philippines? Despite the pandemic, the tourism industry will continue to be resilient, and with your help, we know that we could rise again. We, the heroes, will continue to be superheroes, promoting and spreading our culture, ecotourism, tourism, and hospitality. Did you guys have fun? As much as I want to spend more time with you, we have to part ways now. Thank you and God will repay you. Or in Ivatan, Dios mamahes. I'll be looking forward to meeting you again. Indeed, it's more fun in the Philippines. Sumama, sumama, sumama kayo.